was mentioned earlier this morning, the National Australia Bank believes it's fixed the computer glitch, which left thousands of customers without their pay. And joining us now live from the bank is spokesperson George Wright. Good morning, George. Thanks for your time this morning.
No problem.
Can we just start by clarifying, George, exactly what caused this problem? Because there was speculation it was human error, but you believe it was caused by a computer glitch. Is that correct?
That's correct. The problem was caused by a corrupt file in the overnight processing on Wednesday night, which resulted in that processing not going ahead. As we worked to rectify that, we also, throughout the course of Thursday, we also encountered some problems with the processing on Thursday and Friday nights. But over the course of the weekend, we have now undertaken that processing, and for the vast majority of NAB customers, their accounts are thankfully now up to date, accurate, and operating as normal.
George, there is also speculation or some type of evidence that there was criticism that your computer system at NAB needed some serious upgrading. Now you're saying, quote, this is hopefully a one-off incident. Are you hoping, or can you guarantee that this is a one-off incident and it won't happen again?
We are very confident this is a one-off incident. We've identified the problem and we have fixed it. We will, of course, once we've rectified all the customer issues and made sure that we've addressed people who may have been out of pocket as a result of these delays, we will, of course, do a complete review. But it is a one-off, and we've identified the problem and we believe we've fixed it.
George, it caused widespread chaos over the weekend, especially with even people using credit cards or if they had direct debit, for example, with their telephone being cut off. Are you going to reimburse customers for those out-of-pocket costs?
We would certainly, people who believe they have suffered an out-of-pocket cost, we don't want to see that happen. We would encourage them to contact us and we will work with them to try and put the situation right.
We can see the vision there that you've actually taken out full page ads today in newspapers apologising. What can people do if they have had problems and want to contact you?
They can call our call centre. I would ask for a little bit of patience on that because obviously the volume of traffic at the moment is very high. But what I can say is that for NAB customers who may have been inadvertently charged a fee by the NAB, we will put a process in place where we will proactively identify that and address it. But if people have been charged a fee or whatever from another institution, I would encourage them to contact us at our call centre or through a branch, and we will work with them to right that situation. I do have to ask people be a little bit patient because we've got a lot of work to get through, but we will rectify those situations.
And just finally, George, just quickly, do you think this highlights the dangers of modern technology? People are quite concerned that their money's in the bank.
I can absolutely assure people that the issue here is about delays. It's not about the security of the system. Everyone's accounts will be brought up to date and accurate. Technology, for a lot of people, has made banking a lot more convenient. People can access their money 24/7, etc., etc. This is a very unfortunate situation, but it doesn't indicate a systemic issue.
All right. Thanks so much for joining us this morning, George Wright from the NAB.
It's a pleasure.